أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتخذوا عدوي وعدوكم أولياء تلقون إليهم بالمودة وقد كفروا بما جاءكم من الحق يخرجون الرسول وإياكم أن تؤمنوا بالله ربكم إن كنتم خرجتم جهادا في سبيلي وابتغاء مرضاتي تسرون إليهم بالمودة وأنا أعلم بما أخفيتم وما أعلنتم ومن يفعله منكم فقد ضل سواء السبيل.
O you who have believed, do not take my enemies and your enemies as allies, extending to them affection while they have disbelieved in what came to you of the truth, having driven out the Prophet and yourselves only because you believe in Allah, your Lord. If you have come out for jihad in my cause and seeking means to my approval, take them not as friends. You confide to them affection, but I am most knowing of what you have concealed and what you have declared, and whoever does it among you has certainly strayed from the soundness of the way.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu la tattakhidhu aduwwi wa aduwwakum awliya. Now this is that polarization which I said. Hizbullah and Hizbul Shaitan. Unless this polarization is complete, you cannot hope to succeed in the conflict. It has to be very pure. O you who believe, don't make friends with my enemies and your enemies. تُلْقُونَ إِلَيْهِمْ بِالْمَوَدَّةِ Offering them love. وَقَدْ كَفَرُوا بِمَا جَاءَكُمْ مِنَ الْحَقِّ Although they have rejected and disbelieved what has come to you from the truth. يُخْرِجُونَ الرَّسُولِ وَإِيَّاكُمْ They are the ones who expelled the messenger of Allah. And also you, أن تؤمنوا بالله ربكم. And your fault was only this, that you believe in Allah, your Lord. إن كنتم خرجتم جهادا في سبيل لي. Had you come out from Mecca to make jihad in my way, why did you leave Mecca at that time? You could have stayed over there. Your migration from Mecca was so that the whole force of the Muslims comes at one point. So that from that base, an attack on the kuffar of Makkah can be launched. You must have some base. And there the whole force should be gathered. That was the reason why this hijrah was made compulsory. Compulsory. مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ وَلَايَةٍ مِنْ شَيْنَ حَتَّى يُحَاجَرُوا So much so that it was said that unless these Muslims who claim to be Mu'mins, but they are not making hijrah, they are not immigrating to Medina, you have no connection with them. Till they immigrate. So here also, إِن كُنْتُمْ خَرَجْتُمْ جِهَادًا فِي سَبِيلِ وَابْتِغَى مَرْضَاتِ If you had come out of Mecca to make jihad in my cause and seek my pleasure, تُسِرُّونَ إِلَيْهِمْ بِالْمَوَدَّةِ You are sending them secret messages of love. وَأَنَا عَالَمُ بِمَا أَخْفَيْتُمْ وَمَا أَعْلَنْتُمْ I very well know what you conceal and hide and what you reveal and say out. وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْهُ مِنْكُمْ Whosoever from amongst you takes this attitude, does this, فَقَدْ ضَلَّ سَوَاءَ السَّبِيلِ So he has strayed very far off from the right path.
إن يثقفوكم يكونوا لكم أعداء ويبسطوا إليكم أيديهم وألسنتهم بالسوء وودوا لو تكفرون.
If they gain dominance over you, they would be to you as enemies and extend against you their hands and their tongues with evil, and they wish you would disbelieve.
إن يثقفوكم, if they overcome you, يكونوا لكم أعداء. They will treat you as enemies. فيبسطوا إليكم أيديهم وألسنتهم بالسوء. And they will extend and stretch against you their hands and their tongues with evil. وَدُّوا لَوْ تَكْفُرُونَ. And they will desire that you should come back to your kufr, come back to the religion of your forefathers.
فَعَكُمْ أَرْحَامُكُمْ وَلَا أَوْلَادُكُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ يَفْصِلُ بَيْنَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ.
Never will your relatives or your children benefit you. The day of resurrection he will judge between you, and Allah of what you do is seeing.
لَنْ تَنْفَعَكُمْ أَرْحَامُكُمْ. Your relationships due to the wombs of the mother will be of no avail to you. وَلَا أَوْلَادَكُمْ, nor your children. يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. These things are not going to count on the day of the resurrection. يَفْصِلُ بَيْنَكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will judge between you and give his awards. وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ. And verily, whatever you are doing,
وكانت لكم أسوة حسنة في إبراهيم والذين معه إذ قالوا لقومهم إنا براء منكم ومما تعبدون من دون الله كفرنا بكم وبدا بيننا وبينكم العداوة والبغضاء أبدا حتى تؤمنوا بالله وحده إلا قول إبراهيم لأبيه لأستغفرن لك وما أملك لك من الله من شيء ربنا عليك توكلنا وإليك أنبنا وإليك المصير.
There has already been for you an excellent pattern in Abraham and those with him, when they said to their people, "Indeed, we are disassociated from you and from whatever you worship other than Allah. We have denied you, and there has appeared between us and you animosity and hatred forever, until you believe in Allah alone. Except for the saying of Abraham to his father, I will surely ask forgiveness for you, but I have not power to do for you anything against Allah. Our Lord, upon you we have relied, and to you we have returned, and to you is the destination.
قَدْ كَانَتْ لَكُمْ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ فِي إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَالَّذِينَ مَعَهُ. Indeed, there is for you an excellent example in Ibrahim and those who were with him. إِذْ قَالُوا, when they said to their people, إِنَّا بُرَاءُ مِنْكُمْ, we are quit of you, absolutely disconnected from you. وَمِمَّا تَعْبُدُونَ, and also from those whom you are worshipping. مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ, beside Allah. كَفَرْنَا بِكُمْ, we have rejected you. وَبَدَى بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكُمُ الْعَدَاوَةُ وَالْبَغْضَاءُ وَبَدَى, and between you and us, an enmity and hatred had started, and it will remain forever. حَتَّى تُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَحْدَهُ, until you come to believe in Allah, Allah alone. So this is the conflict. محمد رسول الله والذين معه أشداء على الكفار رحماء بينهم. We read it in Surah Al-Fath in the end. This relationship of love and friendship of a mu'min, truly believing mu'min, can be only with a mu'min. إنما وليكم الله ورسوله والذين آمنوا. Verily, your friend and protector is only Allah and His Messenger and those who have faith, who have iman. إِلَّا قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ, except one saying of Ibrahim, لِأَبِيهِ, which he said to his father, لَأَسْتَغْفِرَنَّ لَكَ, I will definitely ask for forgiveness for you. وَمَا أَبْلِكُ لَكَ مِنَ اللَّهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ, although I don't own anything about you, I have no authority about you regarding you from Allah. رَبَّنَا عَلَيْكَ تَوَكَّلْنَا وَإِلَيْكَ أَنَبْنَا وَإِلَيْكَ الْمَصِيرُ. Our Lord, we put our trust in you and we turn to you, and to you is the final and eventual return. Now this was the only exception, but we have read in Surah At-Tawbah that in the end Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam, he declared himself away from his father also. When he came to know that he is aduwwan lillah, that he is a bitter enemy to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then he said, okay, now there's no relationship between you and me.
رَبَّنَا لَا تَجْعَلْنَا فِتْنَةً لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَاغْفِرْ لَنَا رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ.
Our Lord, make us not objects of torment for the disbelievers, and forgive us, our Lord. Indeed, it is you who is the exalted in might, the wise.
رَبَّنَا لَا تَجْعَلْنَا فِتْنَةً لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَاغْفِرْ لَنَا. O our Lord, don't make us a tool of those who disbelieve, tool of trial. You are trying them on us, allowing them to persecute us. The trial is from you, but at the hands of these disbelievers. So as if you have made us a tool to test these people, these disbelievers. لا تجعلنا فتنة للذين كفروا واغفر لنا, and forgive us. ربنا, O our Lord, إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم, verily you are the mighty divine.
لقد كان لكم فيهم أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر ومن يتول فإن الله هو الغني الحميد.
There has certainly been for you in them an excellent pattern for anyone whose hope is in Allah and the last day. And whoever turns away, then indeed Allah is the free of need, the praiseworthy.
لقد كان لكم فيهم أسوة, verily for you there is an example in them, لمن كان يرجو الله. But this example can be followed only by whom? Who hopes Allah, وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ, and the last day. Whosoever believes in Allah, the same words were there in Surah Al-Ahzab. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرَ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. Three preconditions you have to fulfill if you want to follow the model of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرَةِ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. Here too, لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرَةِ, whosoever hopes to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and whosoever is fearful of the day of judgment. وَمَنْ يَتَوَلَّ فَإِنَّ اللَّهُ هُوَ الْغَنِيُّ الْحَمِيدُ, and whosoever turns away from this right path, then Allah is self-sufficient and praiseworthy. He doesn't need anybody.
عَسَى اللَّهُ أَن يَجْعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ وَبَيْنَ الَّذِينَ عَادَيْتُمْ مِنْهُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَاللَّهُ قَدِيرٌ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ.
Perhaps Allah will put between you and those to whom you have been enemies among them affection. And Allah is competent, and Allah is forgiving and merciful.
عسى الله أن يجعل بينكم وبين الذين عاديتم منهم مردة. Is this possible that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring about love between you and those of them with whom you are at enmity? This condition can come to an end, this enmity, when if they accept Islam, if they change their position, from that side they cross to this side. Wallahu qadeer, Allah is powerful. After all, after a few, you may say, not more than 2 years after this conquest of Makkah, whole of Arabia became Muslim. Now that enmity finished. Because they have crossed over from disbelief to belief. So, asallahu yajala baynakum wa bayna lazina aadaytum minhum mawaddatan. Wallahu qadeer. Allah is all powerful. Wallahu ghafurur raheem. And Allah is forgiving and merciful.
لا ينهاكم الله عن الذين لم يقاتلوكم في الدين ولم يخرجوكم من دياركم أن تبروهم وتقسطوا إليهم إن الله يحب المقسطين.
Allah does not forbid you from those who do not fight you because of religion and do not expel you from your homes, from being righteous toward them and acting justly toward them. Indeed, Allah loves those who act justly.
لا ينهاكم الله عن الذين لم يقاتلوكم في الدين ولم يخرجوكم من دياركم أن تبروهم وتقسطوا إليهم إن الله يحب المقسطين. Indeed, Allah doesn't forbid you regarding those who never fought against you and who never expelled you from your houses, that you be kind to them and deal with them justly. This is the point that I made clear in regarding the ayah number 13 of Surah Al-Hujurat, that Muslim society, Muslim state, it has its own boundaries. The member of a Muslim society is only a Muslim. Full citizen of an Islamic state is only a Muslim. But there are two relationships of these Muslims with all the mankind. One is that the same Allah created them who created us. Number two, they are also the progeny of Adam and Eve, alayhim as-salam, just like us. So a friendship, a fraternity, a brotherhood, it can go on. But those who are hostile, who are opposing Allah, يُحَادُّونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ, the matter is different. Now they are your enemies. You have to be very severe on them, very strict, very hard. مُحَمَّدُ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ وَالَّذِينَ عَامَلُوا وَأَشَدَّعُوا لِكُفَّارِ رُحَمَعُوا بَيْنَهُ. So this is it. لا ينهاكم الله عن الذين لم يقاتلوكم في الدين. Allah doesn't forbid you to have relations with those who never fought you against you regarding deen. ولم يخرجوكم من دياركم, they never expelled you from your houses. أن تبروهم, that you show them kindness. وتقسطوا إليهم, and you deal with them justly. إن الله يحب المقسطين. Verily Allah likes and loves those who are equitable.
إنما ينهاكم الله عن الذين قاتلوكم في الدين وأخرجوكم من دياركم وظاهروا على إخراجكم أن تولوهم ومن يتولهم فأولئك هم الظالمون.
Allah only forbids you from those who fight you because of religion and expel you from your homes and aid in your expulsion, forbids that you make allies of them. And whoever makes allies of them, then it is those who are the wrongdoers.
إنما ينهاكم الله عن الذين قاتلوكم في الدين. Allah is forbidding you from making friendship and taking them as friends those who fought against you في الدين, regarding your deen. وَأَخْرَجُوكُمْ مِنْ دِيَارِكُمْ and they expel you from your homes. وَظَاهَرُوا عَلَىٰ إِخْرَاجِكُمْ and they helped each other, supported each other in your expulsion. أَنْتَ وَاللَّهُمْ that you become friends with them. وَمَنْ يَتَوَلَّهُمْ and whosoever becomes a friend with them, فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ then definitely they are the evildoers.
يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا جَاءَكُمُ الْمُؤْمِنَاتُ مُهَاجِرَاتٍ فَامْتَحِنُوهُنَّ اللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ بِإِيمَانِهِنَّ فإن علمتموهن مؤمنات فلا ترجعوهن إلى الكفار لا هن حل لهم ولا هم يحلون لهن وآتوهم ما أنفقوا ولا جناح عليكم أن تنكحوهن إذا آتيتموهن أجورهن ولا تمسكوا بعصم الكوافر واسألوا ما أنفقتم وليسألوا ما أنفقوا ذلكم حكم الله يحكم بينكم والله عليم حكيم.
O you who have believed, when the believing women come to you as emigrants, examine them. Allah is most knowing as to their faith. And if you know them to be believers, then do not return them to the disbelievers. They are not lawful wives for them, nor are they lawful husbands for them. But give the disbelievers what they have spent, and there is no blame upon you if you marry them when you have given them their due compensation. And hold not to marriage bonds with disbelieving women, but ask for what you have spent, and let them ask for what they have spent. That is the judgment of Allah. He judges between you, and Allah is knowing and wise.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا جاءكم المؤمنات مهاجرات فامتحنوهن. Now, behind this, these ayat is also an incident. At the Treaty of Hudaybiyah, because I told you these ayat were revealed in the 8th year. When the Hudaybiyah Treaty was concluded, it was decided that if some Muslim comes from Makkah to Medina, runs away, his parents or his relatives had tied him down in chains, but now somehow he broke the chains and come over to Medina, he will have to be returned. But if someone from Medina goes and joins Kufar, the Kufar of Medina will not, of Makkah will not return him. This was one of the two unequal terms. But what about women? This question was not settled at that time. And it was a sensitive issue, a relationship of marriage. A Muslim has migrated, the wife is there, and she is kafira, mushrika. Is she still your wife or not? Or if a woman in Makkah, she embraces Islam and comes over to Medina, are you bound to return them according to the term of the Treaty of Hudaybiyah? But then such a case came before the Prophet, he decided no. The terms of Hudaybiyah contracts never covered women. They are exempt. If a Muslim woman, he comes to Medina, she will not be returned. But there was a possibility, maybe the mushrikeen, the enemies are sending spies in their guise. So this is the instruction. when some mu'min woman comes over from Makkah to Medina, then test her whether she is really a mu'min or not. Ya ayyuhal ladheena amanu iza jaakumul mu'minat wa muhajiratin, who you believe, when mu'min, believing women come to you, immigrating, famtahinuhunna, so test them. Allahu alamu bi imanihinna. Allah very well knows whether they have iman or not. And nobody can know it surely. But you can guess, you can judge. Talk to them. You will come to know whether she is sincere mu'mina or not. فَإِنْ عَلِمْتُمُوهُنَّ مُؤْمِنَاتٍ, then if you conclude that they are truly believing women, فَلَا تَرَجِعُوهُنَّ إِلَى الْكُفَّارِ, don't return them to the unbelievers. لَا هُنَّ حِلٌّ لَهُمْ, now they are not lawful for them. Now this woman had a husband and he is a kafir. But due to her becoming a mu'mina, now that this bond of marriage has broken. Now she is not lawful wife of that kafir husband at Makkah. لَا هُنَّ حِلٌّ لَهُمْ, neither are these women lawful for those men. وَلَا هُمْ يَحِلُّونَ لَهُنَّ, nor are they, those kuffar men, lawful for these Muslim women. وَآتُوهُمْ مَا أَنْفَقُوا, now they could say, the kafir husband, I paid her so much dower, so you return. O Muslims, you pay him back. Okay? This woman has entered Islam. She is our sister. She is with us now. You pay so much dower, we pay you the dower. آتُوهُمْ مَا أَنْفَقُوا. وَلَا جُنَاحَ عَلَيْكُمْ أَنْ تَنْكِحُوهُنَّ إِذَا آتَيْتُمُوهُنَّ أُجُورَهُنَّ, and there is no blame on you that you marry them when you pay them their dower. Because now that husband has got divorced. But there is no need of any divorce because he is kafir and she has become a mu'mina. So the bond of marriage is already finished. So there is no harm. Now you can marry him. Marry her. وَلَا تُمْسِكُوا بِعِصَمِ الْكَوَافِرِ, in this same way, O Muslims, you don't hold with you those women in the bond of marriage who are kafira, mushrika, and still staying at Makkah. وَلَا تُمْسِكُوا بِعِصَمِ الْكَوَافِرِ, and don't hold not to the ties of marriage of disbelieving women. وَسْأَلُوا مَا أَنْفَقْتُمْ, and you also ask for what dower you had paid to them. وَلْيَسَلُوا مَا أَنْفَقُوا, and let them ask, demand from you what they had spent. Now this is, you know, it seems there's some understanding between the kuffar and the Muslims, because the treaty was there. And this is all being done in that special environment of that treaty. ذَلِكُمْ حُكْمُ اللَّهِ, this is the command of Allah. يَحْكُمُ بَيْنَكُمْ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decides between you and commands you. Wallahu alimun hakeem, and Allah is all knower, all wise.
وَإِن فَاتَكُمْ شَيْءٌ مِّنْ أَزْوَاجِكُمْ إِلَى الْكُفَّارِ فَعَاقَبْتُمْ فَآتُوا الَّذِينَ ذَهَبَتْ أَزْوَاجُهُمْ مثل ما أنفقوا, واتقوا الله الذي أنتم به مؤمنون.
And if you have lost any of your wives to the disbelievers, and you subsequently obtain something, then give those whose wives have gone the equivalent of what they had spent, and fear Allah, in whom you are believers.
فَإِنْ فَاتَكُمْ شَيْءٌ مِنْ أَزْوَاجِكُمْ إِلَى الْكُفَّارِ, now if any part of doors of your wives has passed away from you to the disbelievers, so فَعَاقَبْتُمْ, so when you have your turn of triumph, you have some booty, فَآتُوا الَّذِينَ ذَهَبَتْ أَزْوَاجُهُمْ, so now give some money to those whose wives have gone, and they are not paying back the dowers also. مَثْلَ مَا أَنْفَقُوا, whatsoever they have spent on those wives who remained back in Mecca. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ الَّذِي أَنْتُمْ بِهِ مُؤْمِنُونَ, and have fear of Allah, on whom you believe, on whom you have faith and trust.
يا أيها النبي إذا جاءك المؤمنات يبايعنك على ألا يشركن بالله شيئا ولا يسرقن ولا يزنين ولا يقتلن أولادهن ولا يأتين ببهتان يفترينه بين أيديهن وأرجلهن ولا يعصينك في معروف فبايعهن واستغفر لهن الله إن الله غفور رحيم.
O Prophet, when the believing women come to you pledging to you that they will not associate anything with Allah, nor will they steal, nor will they commit unlawful sexual intercourse, nor will they kill their children, nor will they bring forth a slander they have invented between their arms and legs, nor will they disobey you in what is right, then accept their pledge and ask forgiveness for them of Allah. Indeed, Allah is forgiving and merciful.
Ya ayyuhan nabi idha ja'akal mu'minatu yubayyi'naka. Now this is the subject of bay'ah again. Bay'ah we had, number one, in Surah At-Tawbah. Inna Allah ashtara min al-mu'minina anfusakum wa amwalakum min lahum al-jannah. And in the end, fastabshiru bi bay'ikum allazi bay'atum bih. This bond of iman is a bond of, it's a matter of sale and purchase. A believer, he sells himself and his belongings to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the price is Jannah. But then on that basis, this bay was taken by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُبَايَعُونَكَ إِنَّمَا يُبَايَعُونَ اللَّهِ. And we have read it in Surah Al-Fath. Verily, who are giving you their bay, who are pledging themselves to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, actually, they are giving their bay'ah to Allah. Over your two hands, hand of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the hand of the person who was giving bay'ah, there is a third hand also, yadullahi fawqa aydihim. Allah's hand is over their hands. So it's a tripartite agreement. Sale deed is between Allah and the believer mu'min. But now, the believer mu'min will spend his life, his time, his money, according to the command of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now this bay'ah was the basis of this jama'ah that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam established. So there is a hadith in Sahih Bukhari, Sahih Muslim both, from Ubadah ibn Sabit radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Bayana Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ala sam'i wa ta'ati fil usri wal yusri wal manshati wal makrahi wa ala asaratin alayna wa ala la nunazil amra ahlahu wa ala an naqula bil haqqi aina ma kunna la nakhafu fillahi lawmat al-la'i. Articles of bay'ah. We pledge ourselves to the Messenger of Allah that we shall listen to whatever he says. Number one. Number two, obey him. Number three, fil usr, whether it is difficult. Number four, or easy. Number five, fil manshat, whether we feel like doing it, feel inclined towards that. Wal makra, or we have to force ourselves to do it. Wa ala asaratin alayna, although others might be preferred to us, we shall never say we are your old friends and old comrades, old servants. How come you have appointed a newcomer as Amir on us? No, no, it's your prerogative. You fix whomsoever you like. وَعَلَىٰ أَلَّا نُنَازِ الْأَمْرَ أَهْلَهُ. And we shall not quarrel with those whom you place at the helm of affairs regarding discipline. قال أن نقول بالحق أينما كنا لا نخاف في الله لومة لائم. But we shall give our honest opinions every what, all times, everywhere, anywhere we shall be, wherever we shall be. And we shall not fear that may people laugh at it, what he is saying. So this 9 articles of bayah, muttafaqun alayh, Bukhari and Muslim both contains this. But now, Quran mentions the bayah of men. But these articles of bayah are not given in Quran. They are in the hadith, although it is muttafaqun alayh hadith. Regarding authenticity is very close to Quran. Muttafaqun alayh hadith, regarding its authenticity, comes very close to Quran. But regarding women, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them a privilege that their bayah, the items of bayah are given here in ayah. Ya ayyuhan nabi, O nabi, O messenger, O prophet. Iza ja'aka al-mu'minatu yubayyinaka. When believing women come to you to pledge themselves. Allah, now these are the articles. Allah yushrikna billahi shayyan. Number one. They will not associate with Allah anything. Wala yasrikna. And they won't steal. Wala yaznina. They won't commit adultery. وَلَا يَقْتُلْنَا أَوْلَادَهُنَّ. They will not kill their offspring. وَلَا يَعْتِينَ بِبُّهْتَانٍ يَفْتَرِينَهُ بَيْنَ يَدِيَهُنَّ وَأَرْجُلِهِنَّ. And they will not come up with a calumny, slander, that they might forge between their hands and their feet. And that they will not, lastly, 6. وَلَا يَعْصِينَكَ فِي مَعْرُوفٍ. That they will not disobey you in whatever is right, that is within the limits of the Sharia. 6 articles of bayah for women. Now what was the benefit of this bayah? The women folk also had a feeling that we belong to this party. Although the active, you know, participation in jihad and qital, that was not binding on them. But a sense of belonging to a group, belonging to a party. This jama'ah, concept of jama'ah is so important that women should also be included in that. فَبَعْيَهُنَّ So, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, accept their bayah, وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُنَّ اللَّهِ and ask Allah forgiveness for them. إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ Verily Allah is forgiving, mercy.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتولوا قوما غضب الله عليهم قد يئسوا من الآخرة كما يئس الكفار من أصحاب القبور.
O you who have believed, do not make allies of a people with whom Allah has become angry. They have despaired of reward in the hereafter, just as the disbelievers have despaired of meeting the companions of the graves.
Ya ayyuhallazina amanu la tatawallaw qawman ghadiba Allahu alayhim. Now this is the final touch of this discussion which we have from Suratul Mujadila, Suratul Hashr, this conflict, Hizbul, shaitan. Final. La tatawallaw qawman ghadiba Allahu alayhi. Don't make friends with those. Allah's wrath is on them. On whom there is wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have rejected the faith. They are opposing Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They are resisting the establishment of the deen of Allah on earth. Don't make friends with them. قَدْ يَيْسُوا مِنَ الْآخِرَةِ كَمَا يَيْسَ الْكُفَّارُ مِنَ أَصْحَابِ الْقُبُورِ. These people have despaired absolutely from hereafter. Just as the disbelievers despair. Despairs who are the inmates of the graves, they have despaired. Despaired of what? They have despaired from the mercy of Allah. They know. We are not going to have any mercy. Or they have despaired that these kuffar have despaired that those who are in graves that cannot be resurrected. These are the two ways in which this ayah has been translated.